Welcome back, folks, here to playonsports.com, your destination for high school sports. Excuse me while I get my my collective breath under control here. Joey Gonzalez alongside Jason Patterson getting set to bring you the Division IV Boys Sac-Joaquin Section Championship between the number 4 Liberty Ranch Hawks out of Galt and the second-seeded Summerville Bears out of Tuolumne. Should be an interesting matchup as both of these two squads are going up for their first ever section championship in school history. So a big deal for both of these squads. Taking a look here at Summerville. Summerville out of the, and I had my notes here, Summerville out of the Motherlode League. They finished first of the Motherlode League. Come in with a tremendous big front line going 6-7. 6-7 and 6-6 along the front line. So a big, tall lineup there for Liberty Ranch. Liberty Ranch out of Galt. They finished second in the Sierra Valley League. And I want to go ahead and turn my attention here to Jason Patterson, my analyst here for tonight, this afternoon's ball game. Jason, a tough lineup, a tall task, so to speak, here for the Liberty Ranch Hawks.
Yeah, I would definitely agree with that. I was standing courtside as the Bears happened to walk out onto the court, and they are really, really, really tall out there. And they happened to just tower over me. I stand 6 foot even, and 85-90% of that team was taller than I was. So they have a lot of work ahead of them if they want to get into the interior.
Absolutely. Want to give you a quick look at the starting lineups here as they're being announced. Give you a quick look at the starting lineups here first for the Liberty Ranch Hawks. Coming again out of Galt, coached by Coach Josh Williams out of the Sierra Valley Conference. Starting at guard, it is number 2, Matt Thomas, a 5'11 senior. At the other guard, it is number 34, a 6'2 senior, Michael Meserol, who is actually the section's top scorer here out of Liberty Ranch. Starting at forward is Matt Hagan. I'm sorry, at the other guard is number 21, Chris Childs, a junior. At the one forward is number 20, Matt Hagan. And at the second forward is a sophomore, number 24, DeAndre Stallings. Taking a look at the Summerville lineup. We'll give you a quick look here at the Summerville lineup. Starting at guard, number 24, Logan Foster, a senior. At the other guard, number 34, Joey Brocchini, a senior. He's number 34. At one forward, it is number 40, Rosendo Amaya Wood, stands 6'7", a senior. At a small forward, it is number 44, Jesse Roberson, a 6'6", forward, also a senior. And in the middle is Connor Morningstall, a 6'7", senior, number 42. So again, just going down that lineup, you know, one of the interesting facts here, Jason, is taking a look at the Liberty Ranch lineup. They don't have anybody that goes taller than 6'4". I mean, they do have Nick Friend, who stands 6'7", but he's not part of the starting lineup. So going to be interesting here, taking a look here, the way that Liberty Ranch is going to go ahead and defend Summerville.
Yeah, they are all huge as we're looking over these stats here. Summerville, the shortest kids on their team are 5'11", so just shy of 6 feet for every kid on their team. So this is definitely going to be an interesting matchup. Like you said, Summerville is looking for their first championship. They've been to the section championship twice and was unable to pull one out. So they are 0-2 in section championships as Liberty Ranch is coming in with only their third varsity season and already making it to the section championships. So hats off to that program as they are a young program and already making it out here to Sleep Train Arena.
Yeah, as you said, their third varsity season, very great job here by Coach Josh Williams, who took over for the program right at the start of the season. They had their first two seasons were losing seasons, came away with 4 wins in their first varsity year. Only six wins last year, and a finish with 22-8 this year. Just an unbelievable jump. A lot of it has to do with Josh Williams, but also taking a look over at Michael Meserol, who again leading the section. Summerville, coached by Ben Watson. You've got an interesting story here on their former coach, Marlon Ronson here, Jason.
Yeah, Marlon Rontin happened to pass away a couple years ago, but he was so big to the Summerville school out there in the city of Tuolumne that they just left him on the roster as head coach. And that is what I had down here, and I went down there to ask how to pronounce that name. And they told me that Ben Watson had taken over, but to go ahead and just give a little shout-out to Marlon Rontin and let him know that his old demeanor is still around this team.
Yeah, and speaking with talking with Coach Watson, he said, you know, Coach Rontin was so important to the program that it didn't matter that Coach Watson was listed as a head coach in most of the rosters. So they keep that there in memory there of Coach Rontin and the Summerville Bears. So at the line here, looking for their first points for Summerville. That is number 24, Logan Foster. Logan Foster coming in, believe he is Summerville's leading scorer.
He's shooting on the hard side of the court right now with all of Liberty Ranch's following behind the hoop. And he ends up draining the second one. So he hits one of two there and brings Summerville within 1 point.
Yeah, there you go. Foster, the averaging 13.4 points per contest here for the Summerville Bears. And Summerville showing their size right away, and probably not a smart foul there against Liberty Ranch is Michael Mesrill. If he's going to stay in this game, I mean, you're going to need, if Liberty Ranch is going to look to come away with this one, you're going to need Mesrill down the stretch, and you cannot be picking up cheap fouls in the backcourt.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of that throughout this championship weekend. Those leading scorers and just big names on their team ending up fouling out come the fourth quarter, and it has costed a couple of these teams here.
Amaya Wood unable to convert there at the rim. Here's Mesrill looking for an opening. Going to be interesting to see how Summerville defends Mesrill. Blocked up at the top there. Amaya Wood coming down with the rebound. And Liberty Ranch not afraid of taking it inside against this big 6'6 plus front line up here, front line of Summerville. The kick out up top. Right at the elbow, that's Morningstar. 6'7 forward. There's a three from Summerville, and Summerville takes the lead as Joey Brocchini, the senior. I'm sorry, that's not Brocchini. As Logan Foster knocks down the three. Check that. That is Brocchini. So Thomas out to Mesrill looking for his first three. No good. Rebound out to Summerville. Summerville being patient. Driving the lane and getting the whistle. That is J.C. Roberson. And interesting fact to note here, Jason, is that despite the size here of the front line of Summerville, Jesse Roberson looking, he's really got some ball handling skills, handles the ball like a guard or a small forward.
Well, yeah, just looking into the NBA, the taller you are does not mean you don't know how to handle the ball, as LeBron James is probably 6'6" himself. So just because you're tall does not mean you don't know how to handle it, and he's out there proving that these tall guys can handle the ball, moving the rock fairly well.
Well, that's really changed in the last few years. I mean, you want to go back even further than that. Take a look at, you look at Nowitzki, who is 7 feet and can really handle the rock. Unlike the olden days, you know, going back further, way beyond that, of course, the ever-great Magic Johnson stands 6'9", at one point was the tallest point guard in the NBA. And that's why a lot of times LeBron James' game gets compared to Magic Johnson, because not only was he able to dish, but stands about the same height as Magic Johnson did, right around 6'9".
Yeah, I'm curious to see how much Liberty Ranch keeps trying to attempt the interior, as they've met one of their big twin towers underneath. He was able to draw the foul, and he hits his first one. So maybe Liberty Ranch is one solid team at the free throw stripe, and they'll try to get into the paint as much as possible.
Mesrill going one of two for his first point of the ball game, but out of bounds on Summerville. So Liberty Ranch, an opportunity here to get put more points up on the board. Here's a shot from the wing for Liberty Ranch. That's good. That was Stallings there, the sophomore, for the Hawks, getting on the board to tie this ball game up at 5 points apiece.
Yeah, that was a beautiful form there And he just went up, drained the short little bucket, nothing but net, exactly what you want. You want to try to get those interior shots off. And if you're going to get a good look, you want to put them in. He did exactly that.
Nice interior passing, almost going down there. Scrum on the ground, on the floor. We're going to get a jump ball. Possession arrow favoring Liberty Ranch. 4:34 to go here in the first quarter. They get some moisture on the floor. You've seen that that has been somewhat of an issue here throughout this, throughout the tournament here, Jason, is moisture on the floor and players slipping, especially over there on that far sideline as Liberty Rand Stallings knocks down the three to take an 8-5 lead here for the Hawks.
Yeah, they need to employ some of those kids that happen to be out here for the Kings games that run out every time somebody's done on that end of the court and clean it all down.
A foul here against Liberty Ranch will put Connor Morningstar at the line shooting two.
As the Liberty Ranch following stomps their feet trying to distract the Summerville free throw.
Really like to see the turnout here from Liberty Ranch as well as Summerville. There's a lot of orange in the stands. Summerville coming all the way from Tuolumne. And Liberty Ranch not very far away in Galt, but still a great showing, a small town. And love to have when those small towns really represent here, especially at Sleep Train Arena. This is generally the pinnacle here for both of these squads, for these small schools, these smaller towns.
It's definitely nice to see a following because sometimes, or I should say most of the time, when you're out here covering championships at a neutral site, you don't have too big of a following for either one of the schools. But yet, as I was walking around the concourses, all I heard from the people at the doors were Summerville right, Liberty Ranch left, and they did a good job separating these two followings out, and they are here in the masses.
Mesrall gets his second point of the afternoon, sinks his first free throw. Here's the second one. It is good. So Liberty Ranch, an early four-point lead as they sit 10-6 over Summerville.
Yeah, Summerville needs to start working their big man in underneath the hoop, use that size to their advantage, as it looks like Liberty Ranch might have the speed advantage here.
Try to dump it off inside. Liberty Ranch unable to come with it as Childs knocks it out of bounds. Actually, we're going to get a whistle. Yes. Going to win a whistle, an offensive foul going against Summerville.
It's going to be Connor Morningstar called for the push there as he kind of just shoved one of the Liberty Ranch players out of bounds towards the ball, trying to get the ball back for his team.
You were saying here earlier, Jason, taking a look at the roster lineup here for Summerville, that they don't have a player that stands lower, shorter, smaller, I should say, than 5'11". So pretty much you could say it's an even 6-foot roster. No 5 and under. No 6 foot and under players coming out of that roster here in Summerville.
Yeah, most definitely. Even their lone freshman on the team stands in an astonishing 6'5". So even the young ones are still really tall on that team.
And we're going to get a foul inside against Liberty Ranch. I believe it was Matt Hagen there going to get whistled for the blocking foul. That'll put Amaya Wood at the line shooting two. Amaya Wood this year.
One more for Rosendo Amaya Wood.
As he misses his first one, Amaya Wood on the season. As I'm trying to find his numbers. Well, his numbers are not. There we go. That's going to be why, because I'm looking at the Liberty Ranch numbers. But Liberty Ranch or Summerville will take the timeout here. I'm looking for an indication. Was Summerville here to take the timeout? They'll go ahead and take the timeout as Liberty holding a four-point lead, 10-6 right here on your destination for high school sports, playonsports.com.
Do you want to watch more of your school's great matchups, like the game you're enjoying here tonight? Tell your school to sign up for the Play On Sports School Broadcast Program. The program allows schools to broadcast all their games and other activities on the web. For more information, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
Amaya Wood, only a 67% free throw shooter on the season, so he'll stand in, take a attempted second of two free throws. Coming into the ballgame, Summerville only, I believe, I'll take a look here. Summerville only a 64% free throw, only 64% from the line as, shooting as a team, but able to come away with the rebound here. So a chance, an opportunity here for the Bears to reset. There's a Maya Wood kick out. Gets the interior pass, has the whole opening, cannot get the reverse lane to fall, though. Rebound out to the Hawks.
Yeah, that's unfortunate for the Bears there. With you're such a height advantage, you want to make sure you take advantage of any opportunities underneath the hoop. He was unable to complete on that one, and Liberty Ranch drove down, and it looks like they're going to draw a foul.
Yeah, you said it. What Liberty Ranch is doing, they're doing a great job. They're just playing man-up defense there, Jason, and they're not doing any double-team there on the sides, just going man-up. And it, great job defensively there for Liberty Ranch to withstand that size here of the front line of Summerville, as the first free throw attempt by Thomas is no good. They still hold a 10-6 lead here with 3:01 to go in the first quarter.
Yeah, it definitely seems like the Hawks have came out here and trying to match the size disadvantage they have against Summerville with the speed that they have. And so far it seems to be working, as they seem to be just a little bit one more step ahead of these Bears.
Good footwork there by Amaya Wood, but unable to convert. Good, better defense there from Nick Friend. They're the tallest front court player here for Liberty Ranch at 6'7", as Mesrill's shot no good. And there he goes. He takes a tumble. Again, we're talking about that moisture on the ground. Tip. And you can see right there the rebounding advantage. And that's going to be an interesting stat here to take a look at throughout the course of the game, Jason, is the rebounding advantage that you would expect Summerville to hold. As Mesrill unable to get the runner to go, still looking for his first field goal of the ball game.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be hard to match against the height when it comes to the rebounds there.
Inside, Roberson unable to convert. There's Fran, 6'7", going up against 6'6". And here's Mesrill pushing the tempo. Kick out for the three. Sinks it. Chris Childs gets on the board here for Liberty Ranch. And the interesting thing here is Liberty Ranch out to a quick 14-6 lead. And Michael Mesrill has yet to hit a shot from the field. We got an offensive foul here going against Summerville. That's going to go against 54, Colton Ebers on the illegal screen.
Yeah, that was unfortunate as they had Logan Foster. Sorry, I was looking for his name. Logan Foster had made a nice shot there, and he had that negated due to the offensive foul.
Yeah, it looked like Ebers was trying to get a pick there to free up Foster, but had that forearm up high and picks up the personal. Into the ball game now here for the Hawks is Zach Barnhart, as well as Zach Justice now running the point, and Garrison Halsey. Here's Mesrill. Nice ball handling skills. 15-foot jumper off the back iron. No good. Still looking for his first field goal. But Liberty Ranch still holding a 14-6 lead here with just under a minute to go in the first quarter. Nice interior move there by Ebers. Rebound out to Liberty Ranch, though. Liberty Ranch looking to push. There's a speed you're talking about here, Jason.
Yeah, they like to rush that court, as they've got big boys on the other end of Summerville, and so they figure they can get their little guys down there quicker than the bigger guys, and so far it's been working as they are leading this game by 8 points.
Ebers going to be whistled for the blocking foul. That's two quick fouls there for Colton Ebers. And that's one way that Liberty Ranch looking to attack this front line is get them in foul trouble. Here's Mesrill open for three off the back iron. No good. Rebound back to Summerville. Summerville looking to score. Push tempo.
Yeah, Mesrill is going to have to hit those. That was a wide open look, and he was just unable to hit that one. If he wants to keep his team ahead, he wants to try to convert on some of those baskets, as that was just bad passing there.
It was bad passing from Ebers to McLaurin. I got to applaud McLaurin, though. Nice backdoor cut there by McLaurin, but unable to hold that pass.
I definitely agree. He did make the nice cut. He did all the necessary moves. His teammate was just unable to make a good pass, and that's going to be another turnover here for the Bears.
Summerville only sinking one field goal here is under 10 seconds, and Mesrell looking to score the final bucket here for Liberty Ranch. Opportunity puts a shot up off the front iron. No good. That shot attempt there by Halsey falls short. But Liberty Ranch, despite the size advantage here that Summerville has, holding a 14-6 lead after the first quarter right here on your destination for high school sports, playonsports.com.
Play on Sports is on Facebook and Twitter, giving you news and information and links to great highlights. You can also access thousands of live and on-demand games on YouTube at youtube.com/playonnetwork. Keep up with all the high school action every week from your destination for high school sports, playonsports.com.
Joey Gonzalez alongside Jason Patterson in here from the Division IV Boys Sac-Joaquin Section Final between Liberty Ranch out of Gauld and Summerville out of Tuolumne. Right now, Liberty Ranch a 14-6 lead. And Jason, so far, I mean, what has impressed you here about Liberty Ranch? Because it's an impressive start here for the Hawks.
Yeah, I definitely agree. The Hawks are coming out here. They're proving they are not afraid of the size of the Summerville Bears. And they are out here just moving their feet. They're constantly moving, doing exactly what they need to do, driving the court nicely. And so it has led to an eight-point lead here in the first quarter.
Getting ready to start here the second quarter. And Liberty Summerville they've had their opportunities at the basket, but have only hit one field goal. They're 1-for-12 here so far. So Summerville's going to have to convert at the hole. 3-2 zone here showing for Liberty Ranch, trying to push Summerville out to the perimeter and doing a good job there. There's Thomas. He's going to take full steam ahead for Thomas. Unable to get it the left-hand layup to go. 7:39 here in the second quarter.
Hawk basketball. Yeah, Liberty Ranch is looking real good right now, coming in as the number 4 seed, taking on the number 2 seed, and they are just living up to that underdog status. They are enjoying every second of it at this moment.
Childs unable to hit the 12-footer from the 12-foot pop. Turns the ball over on the out-of-bounds rebound to Summerville. Into the ball game here for Liberty Ranch, number 45, Isaiah Halsey. As you can see,
that was a nice play there by Garrison King Halsey as he made a nice little pick on it, let it roll out, and it was off of Summerville player. So Hawks going to take advantage of this one, and they are looking good. Like only their third varsity season, that is hard to believe, as solid as they are playing here early in this game.
Yeah, McLaurin losing it there for Summerville. And here's Thomas from the top of the key. No good on the back iron. Liberty Summerville trying to clean up on the boards, but unable to convert offensively. Up top there to Roberson. Roberson going against Mesrell. There's a side pop there as Evers sinks the first field goal in some time here for the Bears. Makes it 14-8, Liberty Ranch. Here's Mesrell from NBA range three. Actually, foot was on the line. Follows his own rebound. Love to see that hustle there from Mesrell.
Yeah, that's exactly what you want out of a shooter as he shoots it. Could tell it was going to come up a little short. Ran out there, picked up his own rebound, and they still have an opportunity to put points on the board.
Michael Mesrell is self-proclaimed gym rat. Finds a bucket here just as the ball squirts out into his hands, and Michael Mesrell gets on the board from the field for the first time this afternoon.
Yeah, those points, those 2 points were all because of hustle. It was just nonstop hustle on the point of Mesrell on that entire play, and he was able to come away with 2 points for his team.
Back in for Summerville, number 40, Rosendo,
Amaya Wood checking in here to the ball game for the Bears, as well as number 24, Logan Foster. Liberty Ranch holding an 8-point lead at 16-8. There is Amaya Wood. Can't get the 15-footer to go. Mesrell coming down with the rebound, looking to push tempo. He's going to draw along this big line and force Amaya Wood to foul him. And that's one way here, Jason, that, as you said, Liberty Ranch has shown no fear. They're just attacking that front line here by Summerville.
It almost seems like Summerville wasn't expecting Liberty Ranch to come out with such a big head of steam. Maybe expecting their height to strike a little fear in Liberty Ranch. But nonetheless, Liberty Ranch is coming out here, and they are proving that nothing is going to scare them, and they are looking for their first ever section championships since they are a very young school. And to secure a section championships within your first 3 years of a program, that is hats off to that program.
Well, you can't sleep on Liberty Ranch. They upset top-seeded Colfax, who was always here time and again, always here in the section final. But upset top-seeded Colfax 64-59 in overtime in the semis. So Liberty Ranch playing with a lot of confidence coming into this ballgame. As Michael Mesrall, there is the what you get yourself in. Michael Mesrall picks up a second foul. Had he not gone for that gamble in the backcourt in that first quarter, he would not be sitting here. And now an opportunity here for Summerville to make a push as they're facing a 9-point deficit.
Yeah, like we have been talking about throughout this entire championship weekend, is when those leading scorers, they get those early fouls, that can change a whole game plan there towards the end of the game.
Nick Fran coming down with a rebound, but it's going to get fouled, and already both teams in the penalty will put Nick Fran at the line, shooting 1-1 as Connor Morningstar gets whistled for the foul. And taking a look at his numbers, I believe that is Morningstar's second personal win. If you can get that front line, that Connor Morningstar, one of the stalwarts there at 6'7", as Fred bakes in the free throw. Connor Morningstar picking up his second personal win, and that's one way that Liberty Ranch can attack, get their size in foul trouble.
Yeah, that would definitely help to eliminate the Twin Towers out of your way. Well, they've got three towers. It's 2 6-foot-6 and a 6-foot-7. Or 2 6-foot-7, sorry, and a 6-foot-6. Yeah, they are huge.
Gotta give credit here to Garrison and Housley. He tied up Amaya Wood. Housley standing 5'7". Amaya Wood at 6'7", a full foot shorter. But Halsey tying him up and getting the jump ball. Possession arrow, Liberty Ranch. Liberty Ranch 18-8, 5:36 to go here in the second quarter. Impressive start here for the Hawks. Off the side iron, no good. Here's Summerville. Summerville looking to push tempo.
Yeah, that's what they need to do right now. They need to get it moving. Oh, nice. What a beautiful, beautiful. That was a nice play by number two, Liberty Ranch, Matt Thomas. He was able to draw that charge, planted his feet right there outside of the danger zone is what I'm going to call it.
And, we'll call it the danger zone. Yeah, you said it there is Logan Foster trying to force something to happen there for Summerville, pushing tempo probably a little too hard there, a little too aggressive there for Logan Foster in Summerville.
Yeah, I definitely agree. It's something they need to do is push the tempo a little bit as they are kind of playing a slow-paced game while Liberty Ranch is going full speed ahead. What a beautiful shot that one was.
Foot on the line there for two as Chris Childs sinks it for Liberty Ranch. He is their Hawks' leading scorer so far. Actually, check that. It's just 1 point behind Michael Mesrall, but Chris Childs keeping the pressure on Summerville as now Liberty Ranch takes a 12-point lead.
You know, Joey, that's one thing I do love about covering the basketball games is when they hit those swishes and you hear that net sound of nothing but net, it doesn't get much better than that, especially if you're that kid out there shooting that and you know that was just, you don't get any better than that. It's just a perfect shot.
Amaya Wood at the line shooting two. So a chance to, actually, I'm sorry, 1-1. Unable to cut the deficit here for Summerville. As Thomas go full steam ahead, cuts right through the lane, not able to get it to fall. But his hustle, probably a little over-aggressive there in the backcourt. And for me, you know, if I'm a coach, I love the hustle. I love the aggressiveness from your ball club. But I do not like the fact that it's happening on the back in the backcourt here.
No, I definitely agree. You want hustle full court, not just on one side of the court. But nonetheless, just a lot of fouls here towards the end of this first half, as both teams are sitting at 9 team fouls apiece right now.
Yeah, both teams, we said, into the penalties. So each foul by the next by either side will put the other team in the double bonus. Free throw good there by Jesse Roberson. And Roberson here with three, with two on the afternoon, 2 points on the afternoon here for Jesse Roberson. Trying to cut this Summerville lead with 4:43 to go in the second quarter. Able to cut it in half to 10. 20 to 10, Liberty Ranch. Impressive start here by the Hawks. Kick out there to Halsey. Here's Isaiah Halsey driving the side. No good. Shot was affected there by Amaya Wood. And Jesse Roberson's going to slow things down here for the Bears. There goes Isaiah Halsey coming all the way out, being very aggressive there against Bryce Farrell. And Isaiah Halsey shoving Farrell, put Farrell on the line to shoot two now as Summerville now in the double bonus. First shot off the back iron, no good. Joey Gonzalez alongside Jason Patterson from Sleep Train Arena in the Division IV Boys Section Championship. Producing this afternoon, this broadcast, is the one and only Will McCombs and Victor Adams bringing you all the video here from Sleep Train Arena, home of the Sacramento Kings here in Sacramento, California.
Yeah, it won't be the home for the Kings for long. Regardless, if they don't move to Seattle, I assume that this building will not be the home of the Kings for much longer.
Side pop off the back iron, no good. Rebound to Summerville. And here comes Ebers, finds his trailer, Roberson. Roberson will reset. There's Farrell, top of the key, sinks it. And Summerville trying to slowly mount a charge here, cuts the lead to 7 at 20 to 13.
Yeah, the pace of this game has really slowed down here in the second half of the second quarter, as we've had a couple fouls back and forth. Both teams need to just kind of calm down and play their game.
It was Housie, false slipping, trying to get it out there to Childs. Childs back to Halsey. Halsey trying to interior pass, going to get a kick. Is looking for Zach Barnhart down on the block. As Michael Mesrall, Coach Williams deciding that he's sat for long enough. Michael Mesrall coming out here and needs to look not to be too aggressive here, Jason, as he's already got two fouls. You don't want him to pick up the third here in the second quarter.
No, I definitely agree. He doesn't want to see a foul until far into the second half.
Here's Justice from the top of the key. Very, very short on the three-point attempt. Goes out to Summerville. 20 to 13, Liberty Ranch lead here with 3:08 remaining in the first half. The Division IV Boys Section Championship. There's Ebers on the wing, driving. Found a hole, and without the size there for Liberty Ranch, Summerville's starting to mount a comeback here. Now cut a 10-point deficit to 5. Here's Mesrall looking to get up on the board here in the second quarter. Mesrall finds the ball. Going to get called. Turns the ball over. Summerville out on the run. Good transition defense there by Liberty Ranch, and there's Mesrall.
I still like the hustle from Mesrall, even though he turned it back over there. Whenever that kid's out on the court, he's putting it all in, it all out there.
Good defense there by Childs to stop Roberson from driving. And there is Morningstar from the elbow. Cuts Liberty Ranch's lead all the way down to 3. We've got a hot one brewing right now as Summerville's mounting a comeback here. 2:07 to go. Liberty Ranch holding a 20-17 lead right here on your destination for high school sports, playonsports.com.
We'll have live coverage of basketball from around the country in March as we hit the section and state championships. March Madness will reign around California and beyond as we bring you action from one end of the country to the other. Join us in March for championship basketball coverage brought to you by your destination for high school sports, playonsports.com.
Joey Gonzalez alongside Jason Patterson here from Sleep Train Arena. 2:07 to go here in the Division IV boys Sac-Joaquin section final up. This is the third game of a six-pack of games here. Coming up next, it's the Division II boys matchup, which is going to be a great one to watch here, Jason, between Antelope and Grant. Grant coming up with the upset special, knocking out number two seed Sacramento. Sac High has been here a number of times, but Antelope facing a new opponent here in Grant. So it should be a fun one. Make sure you stay tuned right here on PlayOnSports.com as we've got continuous action into continuing on to the Division One championship from that one between St. Mary's. And I had the matchup here. It is going to be St. Mary's in the Division One girls matchup, Division One girls final. I'm sorry, St. Mary's against taking on Kennedy. And to wrap up the evening, the nightcap, it'll be a nice Division One matchup between Sheldon and Pleasant Grove. But a good one brewing right here in the Division Four between Liberty Ranch and Summerville.
Yeah, what it is here is Liberty Ranch is just missing their shots, and the height of Summerville is proving too much. They're getting their rebounds plenty. Liberty Ranch is not getting any second opportunities as Summerville is pulling down these rebounds. And without a big Nick Friend in there for Liberty Ranch, they don't really have the height to measure up to the Summerville. And Summerville so far has been using that to their advantage with nice interior passing and driving the lanes and getting those interior shots.
Yeah, you said it. Liberty Ranch not doing a good not able to bring down those rebounds. And mounting, able to tie it up there was Connor Morningstar for three. Hits it with a minute 11 to go here in the first half. And Summerville has come all the way down from 11 behind to tie this game up late in the second quarter.
Yeah, that was a beautiful three-point shot there.
Mesrill able to stem the tide for some time and put Liberty Ranch back up on top by two. The drive and layup good. 22-20, Liberty Ranch just under a minute to go here in the second quarter. There's Ebers in the key looking for some room, space. And there's a height advantage. There is, I believe it was Joey Brocchini going up for the rebound and put back. Ties the game up again at 22 apiece. So 26 seconds on the shot clock, a differential of about a few tenths of a second there between shot clock and game clock. Liberty Ranch looking to hold for the final bucket here. Here's Michael Mesrill. Mesrill to try to go one-on-one here on Colton Ebers, perhaps drive the lane, going in between the legs, trying to split the defense, unable to do so. Ball comes out to Liberty Ranch, and Thomas looked like he was got raked across the hands, but no whistle on the drive there, Jason, as time expires. However, there is a 1/10 of a second on the clock. Coach Williams looking for a whistle. As the official is going to bring Summerville back out on the floor. There is a 10th of a second left, so Matt Thomas should have an opportunity here to give Liberty Ranch the lead going into the locker room at the half.
Yeah, that's what I thought, too. I thought they called a foul on that one, as the referee did put his hand in the air signifying a call.
He did whistle. So. He did signify the foul. I saw the other official show give the signal for halftime, but there was a whistle. Halftime clock is starting to kind of tick away, and now we get set as Liberty. Summerville inbounds. And I'll get your quick thoughts here, Jason. Summerville able to climb back all the way and, in fact, finally take the lead for the first time here this afternoon. What is Summerville going to do? What does Liberty Ranch have to do to stem that tide here or to stem that momentum that Summerville is on?
Well, I think they need to get back to whatever they were doing at the start of the first quarter, as it was seemed to working, and it was trying to match their size with the speed that they have. And they kind of got away from that towards the end of the first half, and Summerville started using their size to their advantage, driving the lane nicely and getting all kinds of rebounds. So if they can maybe try to get some more rebounds, can Liberty Ranch, or press that speed, maybe that'll get them going.
Mesereau short in that three attempt, but you could see already defensively how Summerville's size really would played an advantage there, as we got a tie up here, possession arrow favoring Liberty Ranch. So Liberty Ranch will come up with this jump ball. But Summerville doing a great job defensively there, blocking a shot by Stallings earlier there, that last possession by Liberty Ranch. So obviously, as you said, Summerville really starting to use their size to their advantage.
Yeah, again, Liberty Ranch needs to get that guy right there going, number 34, Michael Mesereau. But he can't get too into it, as you already said. He already has two fouls, so he's got to get his adrenaline moving but not go too far and commit some unnecessary fouls.
Yeah, stay smart aggressively on the defensive end. That time, though, doing a great job of attacking the basket, drawing the foul, so he'll go to the line, where today he is 4 of 6, able to get that one to fall, so we'll say 5 of 7, but having a tough time finding the bottom of the basket, as he was only 2 of 13 from the field. That's for your Division IV state scoring leader. Here's Summerville now inside of Amaya Wood. Amaya Wood turns this over. And Mesereau looking to score, being aggressive, hard off the glass, and I'm going to fall. And here comes the Bears looking to storm back. Sinks the three. That was Joey Brocchini coming up big here for Summerville, giving the Bears a 3-point lead and a tribal violation now by Liberty Ranch.
Yeah, it's excuse me, it's almost like the Summerville Bears have a team full of Dirk Nowitzkis out there, as they're all really tall and they all have solid range on the 3-point shot.
Yeah, knocking down 6 threes here. I'm sorry, knocking 2 of 2 from the three for Summerville. Inside give, ready to go to knock it down was Foster. Foster, nice on the lay-in. And now Summerville has opened up a 5-point lead here on Liberty Ranch. Nice backdoor cut there by Mesereau, able to get that shot to fall. And we'll see if that gets his stroke going here, Jason.
Yeah, that seems to be his bread and butter, is try to drive that lane and kiss it off the glass. And he's been proven that he could do that fairly well.
5:54 to go here in the third quarter, and Summerville attacking the basket. Summerville attacking the basket there. As Childs comes out, there's Mesereau for three, able to find the bottom of the net, and maybe Mesereau is going to find his stroke here as he ties this game up at 29 apiece.
Yeah, that was a solid, solid shot by Mesereau right there. Exactly what they want to do, get him moving.
Here's Roberson attacking the basket, unable to go with the first try, able to convert his rebound and putback. J.C. Roberson now 6 points on the afternoon. And Michael Mesereau starting to feel this groove, understands he needs to get this, gets up on the scoring totals up, and Liberty Ranch is going to have a shot.
It's almost like Mesereau is trying to take this game in his own hands. That's a solid shot there by Stallings. I was watching him at halftime as he was warming up, and I think he missed one out of about 15 three-pointers, so they need to get him moving out there on the outside as well.
Yeah, you said it, a big three there by Stallings to get the lead back to Liberty Ranch, but here comes Morningstar there to get the lead back here for the Bears, and pace has really picked up here in the second half, Jason.
Yeah, I definitely agree. Both teams coming out trying to rain on the basket. Sorry. Couldn't get my thought out.
There's Stallings trying to attack the basket, but going up there with the one hand, gets swatted out of bounds. And Summerville, it's going to be Liberty Ranch. Going to have to work here. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Stallings quickly puts it up. No one there to rebound for the Hawks. Ball comes out to Summerville. Here's Jesse Roberson. As Summerville works it around the perimeter. There's a Maya Wood. Side pop of the key. Gives the Bears the three-point lead, 35-32, 4:14 to go in the third quarter.
That was just a beautiful drawn-up play, set a pick on, in the paint, and he was able, Amaya Wood was able to come free right there at the top of the key, or right at the elbow, I should say, and he was able to drain that.
Off the back iron, rebound comes back out to Childs. Childs, nice fake, drive in the lane, no good. Rebound out to Summerville, and Summerville on a two-on-one break, losing the ball, control of it, and picks up the charge. As Matt Thomas stands in to take the charge from, it looked to be Logan Foster. I'm sorry, no, that was on Connor Morningstar. Got out on the break, and I think, Jason, what happened there is Morningstar unable to have control of that dribble is what caused the charging violation against Morningstar.
I definitely agree. That and the hustle of Matt Thomas to get down there and plant his feet. I believe he was the one that took the charge earlier for Liberty Ranch, too. So Matt Thomas able to get down the court nicely, plant his feet, and take the charge and get the ball back for his team.
3:50 to go here in the third quarter. Joey Gonzalez alongside Jason Patterson in Sleep Train Arena. Got Will McCombs producing and Victor Adams bringing you the video here. 3:41 in the third quarter. Liberty Ranch trying to get back into this one. I shouldn't say get back into this one, but looking to cut the deficit here as they're down three. It was Liberty Ranch early on, but Summerville coming back a big, cutting down an 11-point lead here in the second quarter, and Summerville's been on a tear since then. And Amaya Wood continues pulling up points here for the Bears at 37-32.
Yeah, if you ask any coach out there, halftime adjustments are big, and it looks like these Summerville Bears, they took advantage of those halftime adjustments, and they are using them nicely.
You know, a lot of times what may happen to these kids is just the height of the moment, you know, the intensity of the moment being, you know, from smaller towns, smaller areas. This is the biggest building that either of these teams have ever played in, and so sometimes it's just used to getting sometimes it's just about getting used to the enormity of the situation.
Out. Yeah, getting those jitters out indeed. I know if I'm a kid and I'm down there looking down and I see the word Kings on the floor, obviously that's going to make me a little bit uneasy as you're playing where some of the greats have played.
37-34 Summerville. Amaya Wood at the line shooting two, looking to extend this lead. Unable to do it so with that first free throw as Michael Mesral will go ahead and return to the game. Coming in for Matt Hagan. And also Logan Foster checking back in for the Bears as Joey Rocchini will have a seat. Amaya Wood looking to score on that second free throw. Amaya Wood, 0-3. Well, we'll say 1-4 now as he's able to sink that next free throw. 1-4 from the line here this afternoon. And gives the Bears a four-point lead at 38-34 with 2:50 remaining.
Yeah, so far this has been an action-packed second half as both teams are trying to keep, oh, look at that drive in the lane. He was able to draw the foul. That was a nice drive there by Liberty Ranch's number, looks like it's number two, Matt Thomas.
Bills on 40, Rosendo.
That's going to put Amaya Wood in a little bit of foul trouble with his third personal.
Yeah, you said it, and Amaya Wood starting to turn things around here. He's got 7 for the Bears. He's the third leading scorer behind Jesse Roberson and Joey Brocchini.
And Amaya Wood is going to take a seat with his three personals.
Yeah, smart move there by Coach Watson. You know, you need these players. I mean, fouls become a premium here in championship basketball. 2:41 to go. Summerville a 38-34 lead. And Mesral being aggressive, knocking the ball out of bounds. 24 seconds still on the shot clock here for the Bears. Liberty Ranch extending their defense, forcing Summerville to pass around the perimeter. Finds the inside there to Roberson. Able to get around Stallings. Big block up top by Stallings. Must have hit the rim, though, because the shot clock reset. But Liberty Rams still have been able to come away with a turnover. And here's Thomas.
Yeah, that was just nonstop hustle on the part of Liberty Ranch's defense on that one, and they were able to come away with it.
Mesrall not liking that, but good transition defense there by Summerville to come down to collapse around Mesrall, forcing him to walk with that one. So it turns the ball over there to Summerville, and that's the Hawks' seventh turnover of the afternoon.
Yeah, Coach Williams did not look too happy with Mesrall on that one, as he had a little bit of a word with him as he ran back down the court.
Yeah, I think one of the real things that Coach Williams is talking to Mesrall is to play the pace, play his game, but slow things down. Don't get too fast. You know, usually what that means is you play faster than what the moment is requiring.
Yeah, that's easy to do out here, like you said, in the section championships. You just want to move full force forward, and you think that's what's going to get you a championship, and sometimes you move a little bit too fast, as Mesrall gets a nice inside basket there.
Just around Roberson there.
Yeah, just as Coach told him he needs to calm it down, Mesrall does exactly that, and keeps his head on his shoulders nicely and puts that basket in.
There's Roberson, gets the ball stolen, and into the hands of Mesrall, but he will slow things down.
That was a beautiful strip by Matt Thomas there.
Thomas will reset, and Coach Williams really understanding that he needs, as it's under a minute to go now here in the third quarter. Here's Mesrall for three. Knocks it down. Takes a one-point lead here for the Hawks. 37 seconds on the clock.
Yeah, Coach Williams loved every second of that. He had a little bit of a word with Mesrall, and since then he has put 5 points up and two solid possessions for Liberty Ranch.
Yeah, doing it, as you said it there, Jason. He had done a good job of slowing down and getting Mesrall calm. And Mesrall, another side of life, as losing the ball out of bounds there. Looked like Coach Williams was trying to call a timeout there, as I believe it was Garrison Halsey losing it out of bounds. But Halsey never really had control of that ball, so Coach Williams never able to get the timeout. 15 seconds on the clock. Close to a walk. In fact, Liberty Ranch fans wanted a walk. Shot up, but no good. Into the hands of Roberson. Back out to Halsey. Halsey driving. You know, the self-proclaimed gym rat, but also a very, very coachable player. Will listen to his coach and follow his coach's instructions. You know, follow his coach's instructions to a T. You know, has a great high basketball IQ and a lot of instinct, but understands when he needs to be, you know, do what he's being told.
Yeah, no, definitely. The kid's got a lot of talent out there, and that's what the coaches are there to do, is to harness that talent and get them to show it and use it to their utmost.
7:52, just underway here in the fourth quarter, as Logan Foster will go to the line to shoot two. Finds the back of the iron. Logan Foster, only 1 of 4 from the field this afternoon. 1 of 5 from the line. He's got 3 points here for the Bears. Logan Foster coming into the game. A 77% free throw shooter, and he ties it up with his second free throw at 39-39. So you can see Coach Williams, it's really gotten Liberty Ranch to slow things down. That hectic pace probably. Oh, Thomas turning the ball over right in the hands of Foster. A nice spin move and one by Logan Foster. And just unfortunate pass there by Thomas.
Yeah, definitely unfortunate pass there by Thomas, like you said. But I thought maybe he could have possibly traveled on that one. It looked like he might have took that extra little step. But I'm all the way up here. The refs are down there. So yeah, they call no travel. And that's going to send him to the line with an and-one opportunity.
Yeah, great spin move there by Logan Foster to try to put Summerville up by three with 7:33 to go here in the ball game. Front iron, no good. Rebound out to Mesrall. Mesrall looking to push. And he's going to stay aggressive, get the call on Brocchini, and Brocchini picking up his second of the afternoon. Will put Mesrall at the line shooting two. First off, the first one is off the back iron. That's for a player at shooting 79% on the year. Able to hit one of two, so 41-40 Summerville.
Yeah, that's definitely unfortunate. One thing we've been talking about this entire weekend is the lack of the free throw shooting from all teams here in the high school level. Each teams that we've been able to cover this past weekend have had opportunities to win at the free throw line, and more times than not, we've seen them not be able to complete the free throws.
You know, you got to give credit to these kids because they're so used to having a backboard, just a glass backboard, but usually you have the wall behind you if you're
right.
used to shooting in a high school gym. Here you've got fans standing behind the backboard, and so depth perception plays a factor. So despite the great shooting from both teams, they're not used to these baskets, to these rims. So it takes them a little while sometimes to get used to the adjustment here that it takes to playing in a big NBA-size arena.
No, I definitely agree. That see-through backboard with fans waving and trying to get your attention behind there can be a little bit deceiving on the depth perception.
Thomas unable to drive there in the middle. Kicks back out to Meserol. Meserol straight up three. No good. Rebound out to Foster. Foster able to control. 6:46 to go here in the fourth quarter. Summerville with a one-point lead.
We've really started piling them in here for the crowd-wise.
Big game coming up next with Antelope and Grant. Couple of local schools here. Should be a fun one to watch, so make sure you stay tuned right here on playonsports.com as Summerville takes a three-point lead at 43-40. Here's Thomas, fakes. Here's Stallings beyond three. Meserol with 16 seconds on the clock, tries to split the defense. Looking to force a shot, can't get the call. And here comes Summerville pushing, and Kyle McLaurin. Inside, down the middle on the jumper, free throw jumper, no good. There's a Maya Wood putback.
They're just so tall.
They are, and keeping a lot of those balls alive. There's McLaurin from the side pop. Three is good. A six-point lead here for Summerville, the largest lead in the ball game for the Bears, forces Coach Williams to call a timeout with 5:49 to go. Summerville leading here in the Division IV Boys Sac-Joaquin Section Final, 46-40.
Play On Sports is on Facebook and Twitter, giving you news and information and links to great highlights. Follow us at Play On Sports on both Facebook and Twitter. You can also access thousands of live and on-demand games on YouTube at youtube.com/playonnetwork. Keep up with all the high school action every week from your destination for high school sports, playonsports.com.
Joey Gonzalez alongside Jason Patterson here from Sleep Train Arena. Will McCombs producing. Victor Adams bringing you all the live pictures. We've had some great basketball going on this afternoon so far. Start beginning in the morning, beginning with the Division IV girls game between Bradshaw Christian and Bear River. Bradshaw coming out victorious on that one, 50 to 40 over Bear River. And then the last one was a tight one. I had that score somewhere, and perhaps I'll get back to it at some point, get you that score at some point. In fact, yes, it was a Division II girls between Sacramento and Florin. Sacramento coming out on top, 48-37, got tight in the fourth quarter, but Sacramento, you could say, really dominated for most of that ball game. But we got a good one brewing here as Summerville looking to pull away here from Liberty Ranch as they've extended out to a six-point lead. Here's Summerville set up in a 3-2 zone. Thomas looking for a hole in the zone. Summerville doing a good job of keeping everything to the outside. There's Stallings forcing a three, but able to find the net, and it looked to me a four shot there, Jason. Didn't think he had anything.
I've told you that Stallings, I was watching him in warm-up. He's got some range on him, and obviously he can do it with a hand in his face as they answer right back.
Yeah, you said McLaurin able to answer right back and keep the lead at six. 5:04 in the fourth quarter. Liberty Ranch just keeping it on the perimeter. There's Stallings. Meserol, only 6 of 22 from the field. Able to get that three to drop, however, to go 7 of 23.
Mesereau says, you guys want to shoot a three to come back? Well, how about one more?
24 on the night for Michael Mesereau. And Summerville gets the add one. Morningstar able to drop in the lay-in. He will go to the line to shoot the extra point. Zach Barnhart picking up his second foul for the afternoon for the Hawks. 4:35 remaining on the ball game. Chris Childs checking in here for the Hawks. So Connor Morningstar at the line shooting one. Connor Morningstar 1 of 2 on the afternoon. Make that 2 of 3. 52-46 Summerville. Each time Liberty Ranch has scored to cut the lead, Summerville has answered right back, Jason.
Yeah, definitely. Summerville is not letting Liberty Ranch try to have any opportunities as they just keep answering back with the scoring. And it almost looks like Liberty Ranch is just looking for those three-point shots now. They're keeping a lot of their plays on the perimeter.
Yeah, Summerville doing a great job of not allowing Liberty Ranch to get inside. And just then, Matt Hagan turning the ball over and fouling the Summerville. Fouling Summerville there, and so Hagan picks up a foul there for Liberty Ranch, and the turnover back to Summerville. So Summerville's looking to put add points up on the board.
Yeah, I think Coach Williams noticed the same exact thing as they pulled Hagan right out of the game after that little turnaround.
Roberson unable to get the corner three to go. Here's Mesereau. Here's Thomas. Here's three from the top of the key. Front iron, no good. Out to Amaya Wood with a rebound. And Summerville, basket hanging. Joey Brocchini doing a good job beating the defense down the court. And Summerville's biggest lead of the ballgame. Here's Thomas trying to answer right back. Unable to do so. Amaya Wood there for the rebound. And Summerville.
Oh, he's doing it again. He didn't get all the way down there. Number 34 for Summerville. Joey Brocchini is cherry picking right now. And he's doing a fairly good job at it.
Well, his height advantage here by Summerville allows Brocchini to get down. And not only that, as soon as Summerville puts the long shot up, Brocchini's leaking out and beating the transition defense.
Yeah, this Bears team is starting to pull away from these Hawks as the Hawks can't seem to find an answer to the height advantage of the Summerville Bears.
Yeah, they were doing a good job going inside, beating the defense inside earlier in this ball game. But Summerville has clamped down defensively and really stuck to their zone, to their 3-2 zone, and kept everything on the perimeter here for Liberty Ranch in the second half as Summerville now opens up a 10-point lead. Liberty Ranch going to have to look for a run here, Jason.
Yeah, they're going to have to get a couple quick baskets, maybe a timeout or something to get them back into this one.
Here's Thomas. Ball never touched. Even though Chris Childs able to sink that shot, ball never found the hands of Michael Mesereau. And you would think that on every possession, they're going to be looking for Mesereau. Guess not, though, as they were able to convert. And Summerville coming down with another opportunity. Shot up by Brocchini. No good. Rebound out to Liberty Ranch.
This is exactly what Liberty Ranch wants right here. They want the quick buckets followed by solid defense as Michael Mesereau needed that three-point to fall. Unfortunately, it just trickled around the rim, and it comes back to the Summerville Bears.
Summerville, Liberty Ranch, surprisingly, out-rebounding Summerville 29-24, but Summerville beating up Liberty Ranch on the offensive glass 14-9. As they get another shot to drop there, Morningstar keeps the lead here at 10 for Summerville, and Coach Williams will take a timeout here for Liberty Ranch. And Jason, I'll turn to you here at this point. I mean, things look to be going early, good early here for Liberty Ranch. And Summerville came into this game as a favorite, obviously. Liberty Ranch looking just almost happy to be here, but look like they could have had control here early in the game. Second half has been all Summerville, though.
Yeah, if you would have asked me to make a prediction of who's going to win come first quarter, I would have told you that the Hawks were going to walk away with their first section championships. But unfortunately, come 2 minutes left here in the fourth quarter, they are down 10 points to these Summerville Bears. That height is just proving too much. They were using their speed nicely to start the game. Then the speed started getting away from them. They were going a little bit too fast. They slowed it down nicely. That started to work for them. But Summerville, just every time that Liberty Ranch decides to change it up a little bit, Summerville has the answer that comes right back with it. And it has led to a 10-point lead here with about 2.5 minutes to go to the end of this ballgame.
Well, and what's happened, though, is also, I mean, everything has been out on the outside here for Liberty Ranch. Summerville doing a good job in it with their 3-2 zone and keeping everything on the perimeter. And Liberty Ranch has not been able to knock down their perimeter shots.
Yeah, short of number 10 there for Summerville, Kyle McLaurin, there hasn't been too many solid three-point looks there for Summerville.
Thomas inside, found an inside, one of the rare opportunities in the key. So Liberty Ranch trying to crawl into it, but you're not going to crawl into it when you're putting Summerville on the line. As Liberty Ranch now in the... Or I'm sorry, Summerville will find themselves in the bonus. And Logan Foster at the line to shoot two. I'm sorry, 1-1, but Logan Foster is Somerville's best free throw shooter.
Yeah, it's unfortunate for Liberty. 2 minutes left, and they're already in the bonus. So already committed 18 fouls here.
Logan Foster, 3 of 9 from the line today. So not a great night at the line, but still able to stem the tide, able to sink both of those to keep a 10-point lead here for Summerville. Coming up on 2 minutes to go, as Thomas drives the entire length of the floor, cannot get that easy bucket to fall. You know, I shouldn't say easy bucket because he went into the land of giants there.
Yeah, land of giants indeed.
And again, Matt Thomas trying to force a turnover here, over-aggressive, will put Logan Foster on the line. And, you know, coming down late, under 2 minutes to go here, Jason, you've got an opportunity here if you're Summerville to stem the tide, to continue to put pressure on Liberty Ranch, especially if you're scoring points with the clock stopped.
No, I definitely agree. It seems to be that Liberty Ranch is going to be trying to play more aggressive towards these last 2 minutes, so that's probably going to lead to a couple of fouls. And since they're already in the bonus, this Summerville team has no problem taking some free advantages there from the charity stripe.
Logan Foster we'll call Mesrall with the turnover. Getting blocked out of bounds, and cheers here by Summerville fans. A big block there by Logan Foster. It looked like Mesrall was by himself, but in at the last moment came in Foster.
Yeah, that was a huge block, and that's definitely got this Summerville faithful into it.
Here's Thomas, deciding to take the 20-footer. No good, into the hands of Jesse Roberson, and Logan Foster quickly becoming the go-to guy here for Summerville. Some good balanced scoring here by Summerville. Taking a look at their numbers, Morningstar leads all scorers with 12. I should say all Bears here with 12. Brockini only two less than that with 10. But you got Logan Foster with 8, Amaya Wood with 9, and Roberson with 8. So very balanced scoring there by Summerville. So, I mean, what does Liberty Ranch have to do here with a minute 12 to go?
They got to get something going. They're running down. They're putting up quick shots. Yeah, there is only a minute left, but you've got to find your right opportunity. You have to get the high percentage shot and get it to fall, get back, play some defense. You have no fouls to give, so you have to play aggressive defense without fouling them and sending them to the stripe, as they've been proven to hurt you once they get to that free throw line.
Joey Gonzalez alongside Jason Patterson, a minute 12 to go here in the Division 4 Boys Sac-Joaquin Section Championship Final between the Liberty Ranch Hawks and the Summerville Bears. Liberty Ranch got out to an 11-point lead in the second quarter, but since that time, it's been all Summerville as they've turned the tide and now have a 10-point lead, their largest lead of the ballgame. Inbounds finds Morningstar. Able to kick it out to Roberson. Roberson well defended. There's Foster almost losing it there, but Thomas get whistled for the foul, and That's going to be it for Matt Thomas. Matt Thomas, unfortunately, fouling out the senior. Fouling out of this game with 5 points in. Early, good job early on there by Matt Thomas, but picked up three quick fouls here late in this fourth quarter.
Yeah, it's definitely easy to do when you're down 10 points trying to play that aggressive defense. You're trying to get in there. You're looking for an angle on the ball that you think you might have, and next thing you know, you're slapping the guy's hand and you're getting called for a foul. So three unfortunate fouls for Matt Thomas. Nonetheless, he will take the seat. And as number 24 for Summerville, Logan Foster drains his first one, and he's going to shoot a second one here to try to put him up 12.
Foster able to knock down both. And after going 5 of 12 here for the afternoon, so good late free throws by Logan Foster. Here's Stallings driving the lane, able to put up his own rebound to cut the lead back to 10, and Coach Williams calling another timeout, trying to find something, trying to stem the tide here for the Hawks. As 49.6 seconds left on the clock, Summerville leading Liberty Ranch 62-52 on your destination for high school sports. Play on sports.com.
Do you want to watch more of your school's great matchups like the game you're enjoying here tonight? Tell your school to sign up for the Play on Sports school broadcast program. The program allows schools to broadcast all their games and other activities on the web. For more information, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
Yeah, tough shooting night here for Liberty Ranch. 18-59 from the field, good for only 31%. Summerville shooting 42%, but have had it late here in this game. It's been the free throws. They've been beating them at the free throw line, have gone 15 of 29, where Liberty Ranch is only 9 of 16 from the line. 16 attempts there for Liberty Ranch. They need to find a way to claw back into this one.
Yeah, I hate to call a ball game over, but I definitely don't think I'm going to see Liberty Ranch climb back into this one.
There's Housie on the foul against Foster, and pretty much at this point, 39.7 seconds left on the clock. I mean, you want to stem the tide here and continue to put Summerville at the line to try to stop the clock. You just hope that Summerville does not make their free throws. But when you got Logan Foster, the Bears' best free throw shooter at the line, it's going to be a hard game to call. As looks to me that Coach Williams is going to go ahead and concede here as he empties his bench, puts into the ball game now Rance Gale, number 44, Christian Ferris. And as soon as I'm able to see their numbers, I'll let you know who that is. Also number 25, Austin Freitas. And the last Hawk player, that's number 42, Mitch Palmer. Running one-hander by Halsey, no good. And we got to get a foul going against, it looked to be Austin Freitas. And it'll put Summerville back on the line.
Yeah, they had a three-on-one there. I don't know. That was kind of interesting. Three-on-one, and unfortunately for all Liberty Ranch, each one of them at least 5 inches shorter than the person they were all trying to cover.
Well, it's not going to wind up the way that Coach Williams wanted to, had hoped for, but, you know, you got to give it up for Coach Williams. An unbelievable job to start this season, just taking over as coach right as the season was getting ready to get underway and to bring his Liberty Ranch Hawks all the way to the section final and only their third varsity season, Jason.
Yeah, you said it. Just like you've been saying throughout this entire weekend, this season is not over for them either. They will have to go on the road for their first regional game, as Summerville will host a regional champion or a regional game. But nonetheless, these Liberty Ranch Hawks, I expect them to give one heck of a game for whoever they have to play there in their regionals.
And Summerville stemming the tide. They're going to win their first ever section title for the school as Amaya Wood misses the second free throw. Summerville also emptying their bench. That looks like number 50 Reese Moeller out there alongside number 30 Jeff Grabo. And number 14, Eric Freeman. And Summerville is going to go ahead and do it. And you hear the cheers from the Summerville faithful. Their first ever Sac-Joaquin section banner as they knock off at Liberty Ranch 63-52. Folks, stay tuned right here. We're going to give you some post-game notes as we step away right here on your destination for high school sports, playonsports.com.